Bro, it was awesome, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, anything you need to share, bro?
Nothing. I think I covered all. Like, if I had to leave a message, I think I did.
Bro, it was
awesome.
Gobind.
Hi, man.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much.
And another thing. I think this is an ongoing process because tum aur main jab bhi baithte hain, it's like a podcast discussion.
True. Yeah. This is the third time maybe.
Yeah. You've been traveling lately a lot. Tell me about it, bro.
So I do a job with MasterCard that has no traveling. That's like, I feel
that's
like,
a good way to
put it. Yeah, there's a cabin which I'm in and it has no windows. So if I choose not to take a break, I will not see sunlight. Mm. My job starts at 5:30 and it ends at 5:30 in the evening.
Okay.
So on a winter's day,
a job starts at 5:30 in the morning.
Yeah. So I have to get up at 4:45, and I do.
So you have to reach your place.
At 5:30, I have to take this call where we take the business from America, and we say, okay, now you go, because MasterCard has this follow the sun policy. Okay. Nobody works in the night.
Hmm.
So they have my 5:30 in the morning is their 7 p.m.
Okay.
So they do 7 to 7. Hmm. I do 5:30 to 5:30.
Right.
So if I choose not to take a break, I don't see the sunlight.
Okay.
The best part is very few people have access to that room in MasterCard.
Hmm.
It's the head offices in Pune. So if I choose to sleep for an hour also, nobody gets to know. I have my boss.
So tell me you've done that.
I have.
Yeah?
Because I'm working out after office.
Did you ever get a nudge like, what the fuck are you doing?
No. But the thing is, we're a team of four.
Okay.
And we're all humans. And we all realize that, and we have really good bonding.
Bosses aren't human, bro.
Boss is not there.
Yeah.
He comes like around 11, 12.
Right.
And he sticks to like 7, 8. So we have this good unity. And I think whenever the numbers are lesser, creating a bond is much easier.
Yeah, true.
So that's what we do. We like cut each other some slack. Ke, bro, tu so ja, ja break le le, main khana kha leta hun.
Sona is important if you're working, like if you're getting up 4:30.
True. And I have to work out after the gym.
Right.
Because I cannot waste a day, and you know how we fitness freaks are. We have to work out every day.
Yeah, I remember we've crossed paths so many times while walking on that Kalyani Nagar.
I'm going, you're dying. So that's how it is. And in terms of what happens there is great. It's like NASA, but instead of watching spaceships in hibernation, I'm watching the banks all over the world.
Right.
So I can never let any bank die. And that's about it. And if anything goes down, I have to fix it immediately.
Tell me about MasterCard. And you being a software engineer over there?
No. I'm working for software engineers and helping them do their job well.
So what's your background like?
Okay, so I was in Sindhi, Pune. Economics.
Shout out.
And economic honors.
Right.
And I didn't go to college at all. I don't know how I graduated.
Perfect.
3 years ago. In backlogs.
Which Sindhi kid ever goes to college?
No, but mine didn't even have an attendance issue. But exam dene aaja na.
Same, but mine was Jammu University. So, you know, Jammu and Sindhi. So
University?
Yeah.
It's good that you're both from Jammu, so I get him.
Yeah, we've got same roots. Karen, did you know that? Like, Jammu.
You're from Jammu?
Yeah.
My grandmother is in Jammu, so all my summer vacations were in Jammu.
Oh, how?
Yeah,
You don't stay close to each other?
Gandhinagar. Yeah, close.
Very.
Okay.
I could walk from my house to his, if I choose to walk a little.
Let's get back to MasterCard. Right. Yeah.
So MasterCard in 2014 came to India,
hmm.
and they said, well, beyond being just the jury between two banks,
hmm.
let me be the brains of the bank. So they started a new source of revenue.
Right.
And in 2014, I was at home in Chandigarh, unemployed,
hmm.
Trying to crack GMAT and gymming a lot because I was heartbroken. So since I was heartbroken, my body became better than my GMAT score.
Who wants to get MBA? MBA.
Right? I was like, Vapas aa jao. Yeah, I was the dude who would watch Lux before going to the gym. I would watch Rockstar before going to the gym.
Nice, nice.
I'd watch Tourist and think it's one of the most romantic movies ever. So one fine day, Chitrangada comes over for dinner.
You need to...
The actress.
Chitrangada Das.
No,
Singh.
She comes home for dinner and I'm like, huh.
How does like your father...
So my dad and her ex-husband, Papa, like, I don't know what's happening on the news. Her husband are golf buddies.
Was she married to Jeev?
No, Jyoti Randhawa. He's one of the best golfers India has. Jeev and they are like...
We are talking about Milkha Singh's son.
So him and Jyoti Randhawa are like one of the best.
All right. So she's married to Jyoti Randhawa. Right.
So they came over for dinner because
right.
of golf.
Huh.
And I'm sitting and everybody's been polite. Mom's cooked the best food for us since in a decade. Mm. And we're enjoying that. And she says you want to do some modeling.
Yeah.
And you know, you growing up in college, you saw the billboards and your environment tells you that you're good looking. And you've seen Hrithik Roshan, so you also want to be a bloody Tom Cruise or something.
Yeah.
But you never know the way
right.
or how to go. Here she was and I thought, yeah. And next morning I thought it's all talk of the evening and it's not going to materialize into anything. A week later, I find myself walking in Will's Lifestyle Fashion Week.
Right, to buy something.
Out of the blue.
Right.
A week later, she's like, Gobind, come to Delhi.
Yeah.
Will's Lifestyle called me. FDCI, which is the Fashion Direct Consulate of India.
So, Chitrangda gave you a break.
My reference, yeah.
On
in modeling.
Nice.
So, I was treated like royalty also because of the reference I had.
Right.
And I knew I don't deserve it. Because I know I'm a nobody, right? And there I am, suddenly I'm sitting, first day of fittings in Lovett, I'm seeing these 80 women from around the world. So in my head, I'm the guy who's calling his friends in Delhi. Bro, come to Lovett. You don't know where I'm sitting. You don't know what's happening, right? Like, Chitrangda should have been sorry that day. And no friend was free to come. And I'm having dinner with Rohit Bal and Karen Gracious, that model, right? I know I don't belong here, and suddenly I'm walking Qutub Minar for his grand finale, and Arjun Rampal, I see him there.
Rohit Bhatt.
Yeah.
Huh.
And I see him, and I'm like, wow. So I go back home, smitten, right, Damabagh is
obviously,
me.
Yeah.
And I don't know where this agency got my number. They called up my dad, and they proposed him, sir, isko bhej do. He doesn't have to pay any bills.
Right.
70-30 for any job he does.
Okay.
70 goes to him.
Huh.
Dad saw my interest in GMAT. Right, like, ja. He is concerned, but nobody wants to see their son sit at home.
Yeah.
And I was 22 then.
Hmm.
Right? I had just had 2 years of experience with Aon Hewitt as a consult analyst.
Okay.
And they were paying me peanuts because I was a fresher.
Right.
So, he was like, go. And I'm really thankful to him. He let me be secular as a man, not be a Sikh. He was liberal on that front. He's let me pursue modeling, being an army officer.
So, when you know...
I was 17 and I trimmed my beard and I didn't know that you're supposed to keep a comb and trim it evenly.
Okay.
So there were patches and my mother saw me and she slapped me.
Okay.
Not because I'm not Sikh and but because I'm looking so horrible. She's very vain like that. So I decided ki how can she slap a 12th and I was a head boy in my school by the way. So I walked up to my dad and I had long hair. Like if I right now had if I do this, my hair would touch the ground.
Right.
Wow. So you used to dye patka.
Yeah, yeah. All my school life. And in 12th from what I started doing was I started tying a very loose perk and wearing a skull cap. Because in my mind I wanted my hairline to be fine. So I was preparing for college, right?
Yeah.
My parents didn't know this.
If is it a fact that if you know
so you're doing this and you're pulling your hair to
constantly,
make a
constantly
hair, not even hair like today's fashion, right?
Right. Yeah.
Like hair. So that's why there are these Sikhs who don't have a hairline.
Yeah, they lose their hair, yeah, eventually.
And it's an inconvenience, man. I mean, respect to the religion, but we're not fighting anyone today, right? So if it's inconvenient and you still have respect for the religion, in my personal opinion, do what you want. So I'm really thankful to my dad. I walked up to him, he was in his study, having his evening drink. Like, ball caught me. And he did this. Right?
Oh, shit.
Yeah. He's like, yeah, dekh, maine bhi kaatne tha apne time pe, but I couldn't do it. So if you want to, and your mom's okay with it, do it. So I knew that college life is going to be good.
Yeah.
So I go out and my mom is like sitting on the bed and praying while watching TV. Was this multitasking? Right? She's like, "Achhe martial arts mein aur ghar ke bahar jaake jo karna kar le."
That's all you need, right?
Yeah. And all my school life, if I got 70s, I'd be proud of myself.
Huh.
My parents would still be worried. In 12th, I got 87.
Dude.
Commerce.
I got
commerce.
60. Science.
60 science? Respect. Right, tell me, trust me, go calculus went over my head. I'm like, is it cheating? Okay, I'm going to tell you what's going on. Integration, differentiation.
Yeah, I love that.
Some theory.
I love math.
So I was so sure about my educational future that when my friends joined PCMB in 11, then he joined Kirti. So if my dad asked me in the first month of 11, why did you join? Papa, Shahan joined.
But did you know your subjects were?
I gave up.
Gave up.
के बीच में मैं डर रहा था मैं future में क्या करना है ऐसे become an MBA it was the thing that.
हाँ
MBA. मेरे तो science ही ली. पहले पता नहीं. So that happened. I came to college, and first day of college, I cut my hair.
Right.
With this dude, he's no more, God bless his soul. And H2O. Back then, H2O was there in Pune. So first day of college,
H2O.
Yeah. 2009.
You were in Pune that time?
Yeah, so
okay.
I came to Pune for
Symbiosis.
First day of college, I went to H2O. They had it set different place. In very close to Starbucks today.
Yeah.
So that hairdresser, she still has pictures of me when I walked in, opened my skull cap, and hair fell down, and I'm like, God, no. And her first reaction, Karishma's, was, can I take a pic?
Yeah. At that time, at that time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Investment.
So she gave me free haircut.
Right.
Twice, thrice after that, because I think she kept the hair.
Okay.
Kind of hair. So, yeah.
Oh, she probably
donate. Yeah, yeah.
That's
or,
it. I was
or,
in boys hostel after that, played football, ragging was completely fine. I was like, drugs mat karna. And suddenly I walk up to my senior's room and I have this smoke come out and I'm like, drugs. So,
in our university, there was this room in the hostel. It was called G8. G8 was known for, you know, it was a hot box for the whole university, for the whole law school, not university, but law school. Dude, the amount of whiff that used to come out of that room.
So, you know, and the thing was, they were cheap drugs at the time. They would actually have that smell the
thinner and all. No.
Very, like everything.
Yeah.
So, you don't know what they're high on.
Why?
And I'm scared because I'm from a very righteous
yeah.
upbringing right now. So, first day, I was like, you know. And the ragging happened so that on 23rd August, I woke up at 4 in the evening.
Huh.
You know, you're sleeping
yeah, yeah.
in the morning. God woke me up. It's your dad's birthday. You've forgotten it.
Okay.
I was so sad. I was like, shit, I just walked out of my house first year and this is what I'm doing to my family. So I go, I get drunk on beer. So 18, I had my first
because you were sad.
I walked to my senior, said, pata nahi kya karna, and say like, idhar. Let's make you a man today. And at 19, I went and tried my first joint.
Okay.
Myself. So I walked in my scene like I want to try. So the moment I had my first drag.
What happened? I want to know what happened. Did you get
tired? So the moment I had my first drag at 19, it was in my boys' hostel in the shower room.
Okay.
We used to call it Sungri.
Why?
Like four boys sitting in the shower room.
Yeah.
And we're smoking. And the moment I had my first drag, the senior goes, it's a boy. 3 drags later, this part starts feeling heavy.
Right.
And I know I'm high. Mm. Suddenly I'm in a trance in a bit. But not like the show in movie, like,
yeah.
like I'm in a La La Land or something. And suddenly somebody got cream rolls to eat and somebody said something about the cream roll.
Right.
And we started laughing.
Mm.
For half an hour.
Yeah,
I puked and I slept.
Right.
And next day I got up, I was like, joints are nice.
Dude, I'll tell you before I even get you up. My first experience, I was an idiot that I didn't try a joint, I tried a fucking chocolate. And never do that. Like a hash chocolate.
That's too much.
So that's too much because first, chocolates are delicious. Second, you are fucking ignorant. You don't
and
know.
You don't know how much you ate.
So I ate 2 joints worth Akela and it was my first attempt. And,
joints
worth chocolate and you know.
That could be like an OD.
No,
but trust me.
The OD. No.
Yeah, bhang.
But you can't OD on weed. But it takes you some 1,000 joints to get marijuana toxication, cannabis toxication.
Yeah, I had bhang.
But OD, I'll tell you. Let me.
No, that one moment I was sitting and I had the sensation in my leg and I was like, if the sensation reaches my head, I'm gonna die. So the moment it reached my neck, I stood up and I puked.
That happened to me with the chocolate. So I had the chocolate and I had 2 chocolates. And dude, you know, when you eat it, so it is processed by your liver. Cannabis, right?
What?
Marijuana. Otherwise, when you smoke, it goes into your bloodstream
yeah.
and it directly goes into your bloodstream, right?
Yeah.
But when you eat it, right? So it's processed, it's digested. And
so it kicks in later.
Yeah, it kicks in later after and it has a very, very profound effect on
yeah.
your, you know, and I got paranoid that I'm marne wala. I'm marne wala.
See?
See?
I told you.
it was like, dude, I'm going to die. I'm going to die. And at that time, I was like, kar chale, hum sidha ghar so raha hum. And I'm like, dude, if I wake up, if I gave up, pehla, kabhi dubara nahi karunga. But dusra tha.
You sent a message to your mom saying,
no,
I'm sorry for everything.
I was feeling guilty about a lot of things. Like, shit, I didn't do this for my mother, didn't do that for my father. All of this coming to my head. There's a car in front of me. I was getting driven by a friend, right? There was a car in front of me. I was like, mujhme superpowers aa gayi. That's what exactly
it happened. I can believe him because I've been in
his... I was like, ye Wagoner udegi abhi. Udegi. And I was thinking that until then, we haven't taken a different path. So, my thing was...
That's the first time.
First time with chocolate, yeah. So it does creepy, but I think the company also matters. Ki tum kin ke saath baithe ho. So if you are sitting with chill people, like you know, it's a boy or something like that. So you slept.
Anybody
right?
Watching this interview right now, I feel that if you are in college or if you're a teenager or wherever you're with your friends, you know that you're really happy with, you should give drugs a go in your life. I would never.
But like,
ask...
Do you mean like synthetic drugs?
No. Weed and hash and. You know what? Try. Like Steve Jobs said, what have you done in life? You haven't experienced LSD once in your life. So who am I? Like what I'm saying is that it's an experience worth having. You never get consumed with anything too good. So obviously it means you don't get consumed with anything bad also. But try it because the way it makes you think, you can never think like that sober.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel the artist or your creativity really comes out when all your instincts are satisfied. Nobody could sit and paint a beautiful painting if they're horny or hungry.
So
just my.
So it's like you're saying that I'm either horny or I'm hungry all the time.
No.
But I get what you're trying to say. Yeah.
I mean, at that age is the age. Like I've given up joint for what, like 2.5 years now,
right.
And I have no plans of ever doing it again. Though there is a part of me which misses the good time.
Huh.
But to chase the first highs or the. First sex, you know, like you can't do that. So there's a time for everything, and I feel that you make that period of your life.
But then, Gobind, you meet certain people,
yeah,
who haven't tried all of this,
yeah,
knowing that they could have done it,
yeah.
And when you speak to them, they're like, I have other highs in my life. For example, I'm high on good health.
Okay.
There are like people. There are people like that. And then I try to understand that: is it really necessary for everyone to try, or is it just us because we like doing it? Because people are like, I feel. Good when I go for a run,
mm-hmm.
when I come back, it gives me that rush.
Yeah.
It gives you that rush, right?
True.
So when I get that rush out of life,
okay,
you know, and I am pumped that, okay, tomorrow I'm going to push, you know, 1 mile further or something. That gives me the high. And they actually believe in that. I'm like, I'm bagwas kar raha. But, you know, I'm like...
On that thread, I would say that they are better and they've been guided better and they have better guidance. Not denying that.
Mm.
But at the same time, these people...
If they ever
feel the urge at 35, 40 to do it, they should answer themselves or what they've been telling themselves for the last 15 years.
Yep.
So they should not, it should not backfire. It would not
They should feel
me.
Shitty at the end.
Huh.
Shitty ki ani.
At 35, what happens is I have totally evolved from the boy I was at 18.
Hmm.
So when I don't miss the joints anymore,
yeah.
I understand why, because I've done it.
Yeah.
Like when I have an ice cream now, I don't enjoy it as such because I know how it tastes and it would last for 15 minutes. But it would end up making me feel guilty because I'm into fitness, right?
Mm.
I like the way what goes into my body of how, what I'm doing to it.
Mm.
So at the same time, if you are not trying alcohol or drugs ever, you're doing very well. You've had a better guidance in your life than me.
Yeah.
And don't ever go for it. But if you do, you're not your mistakes. You're just experiencing something and it doesn't have to be your life. Mm. You can be above it.
Tell me about your... so-called transcendence, like why did you leave?
So
no smokes, no joints, no alcohol.
Alcohol only now to elevate my celebrations, and they have to come by rarely.
Right.
A promotion, a birthday, somebody's marriage, you really.
Where you have to hold a glass. Events like
honestly, this. I might just get drunk on that night.
Huh.
Because you know what, my friends are not getting married again.
Yeah.
Hopefully. some of them are. sorry. And also, I'm not getting promoted again and again.
Right.
And you know, like, I feel you can't just keep working hard and, like, not... I'm sure Elon Musk also, like, celebrates once in a blue moon when the spaceship, like, launches perfectly. So
I'm just curious how that guy celebrates, though. I don't know whether he drinks or
something. He's dating Amber Heard right now.
Yeah, that's how he celebrates.
That's how he celebrates. Yeah.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah,
he's dating Amber Heard.
Yeah. I mean, this is the e-buzz rumor I have heard.
The one in Aquaman, right? The
yes.
Same.
She was dating Johnny Depp before that.
Wow.
That twisted.
What a resume. What a resume.
I think she's into weirdos.
What have you done last 5 years for Johnny Depp?
now I'm going to pass.
Damn, VIP pass on Mars.
Yeah. Free trip, man. She's smart.
You know, there's this study where they study faces. So her face is kept as a benchmark because it's supposed to be the most perfectly designed face.
What do you call that thing? Golden ratio? Golden ratio?
Yeah.
I'm going to make that meme, man. Golden ratio.
Amber Heard's face just fits in perfectly.
What do you mean by perfectly designed? She was a born that way.
No, no, like, you know, you study the jawline, mm-hmm. the hairline,
yeah.
eyebrows, structure.
I can see her face again.
Now everyone's gonna see her with that thing around.
I can just close my eyes and have her face.
Yeah, she's pretty.
So that was college about, and football, had a girlfriend. But you know what? Here's the thing about drugs. They are never fulfilling. They never fill that void. So obviously, you're not content. You would see these guys into fitness and you would know how to be to that level.
Mm.
You would see them do modeling and you'd be like, how did he get that gig?
Yeah.
Where does he go? Like,
yeah.
You know, because you're just sitting in your room and chilling with your friends, watching Family Guy on a joint.
Mm.
And then you just go as a part of the herd. Ki kya karna college ke baad? Work. Right?
Yeah.
Placement.
Yeah,
MBA
yeah.
after experience, that was the trend then. Now there are views of everybody. MBA pehle kar lo, work experience kar lo, khud apna kar lo kuch. So I've gotten to Aeon in Gurgaon. Hate that city. I
not
don't like Delhi. I don't like Bombay. I worked for 2 years with Aeon Hewitt, earning peanuts in my own house. And in my house, it's a thing that the moment you start earning when you're 21, you don't get daddy's help.
Huh.
And I'm so thankful today in my point, like today,
right.
that I have gone through an experience like that.
Yeah.
Or my dad brought me up like that. There were times there was some resentment towards that fact because I know daddy's doing well. Right? Like, asking for a car or a bike also would have been easy, man. But my dad showed me the value of money the way he brought me up. But he also taught me how to make my own.
Right.
And I'm really thankful to him today. There have been times because, you know, my parents, nobody brings them up to be parents. They also learn their own.
Yeah.
In their own journey.
Mm.
And there were a lot of mistakes from them. And I used to be upset with them about a lot of facts, about a lot of things. But today, if I see of what I've done on my own, you kind of overlook those mistakes like they have overlooked so many of our mistakes.
Mm.
So
if parenting goes wrong, then you can blame. But if they have their personal issues or whatever they've done wrong in their lives, everyone who grows up...
wrong to blame your parents for bad parenting.
Yeah.
It was never intentional. They don't know.
No, you can.
Some people are fucked up. I'm not lying. Some people are fucked up. It's rare. It's rare because apne bachche ko koi nahi karta.
That's probably like abuse
of money. You know, because I've all the good girls in my school I knew.
Huh.
Were never even
good girls.
Good students. The ones you would never even abuse in front of. Because you know they're telling the teacher or they're telling their mom.
I thought
good
you're going to lose your
They're sitting on the front desk
yeah.
and they're answering every question like Hermione.
Nerds. Yep.
Nerds, right? So you automatically have... And if she's a pretty nerd,
mm.
you'll be like out of my league. School ne batata ke meri league nahi hai. She loves to ask her out. 90% of those girls I know, unfortunately, are divorced.
Mm.
In the same age bracket as us. Because they only heard and listened to their parents.
Yeah.
That's true.
I have a very close friend who got married when we were in school. Like, I was 17. You finished 12th in 17, right? So, finished 12th in 17. A very good friend. Her mother got her married and now she's divorced and has an 11-year-old.
They are doing PhD. They are doing getting married.
We were angry, furious with her mother. And her mother didn't let us go to the wedding wala thing and
My
give her the gift. She denied. She was like,
why?
Because we were bros, right? So she always used to talk about us, Abhimanyu. In front of her husband, she must have said, ki haan, mera group Abhimanyu. She didn't let me go to the stage and give the bouquet or stuff, whatever you do.
Wow.
I was like, dude, I was like, listen, let's get the fuck out of there. I told my friends. But my friend had a plan, ek upar mein kata, no, sab kuch do baar khake jayenge.
Achha plan.
Like,
achha plan.
Right.
So, I mean, I'm really happy my dad let me make my mistakes.
That's how you learn, man. Otherwise...
And you know, like growing up, my mom really pampered me. Mera beta. And my dad was like, hey, mistake hogi, right? Like, he'd be the kind of father who would scold me on my birthday. And I'd in my head be like, it's my birthday.
Yeah.
And my mom would be like, it's his birthday.
He doesn't give a shit.
The same man, when he came to Pune to see me off as a 17-something-year-old college, right? He gives me 3,000 rupees as my pocket money. And he's like, be a good boy. And he cries. And that... Then Brigadier could hold himself. So to see somebody who's been so strict all his life to cry, then I was like,
it moves you.
Now I'm
very, very.
That time I was like, Jaona, let my party start. Now I think about it, I'm like, wow, it was all soft all this while. He was just.
Especially
trying to make sure that he raises something good.
We've had this conversation before, especially if your fathers are in forces, paramilitary forces, or whatever. So you've always seen them, you know. Live the life, that life, right? And you don't expect, and you don't even expect to see that because that's the image, you know.
True.
etched in your brain ki haan, tumhara dad aisa hai. And suddenly when you know, when my father retired, and then you see the soft side and you're like, fuck, I don't know this person. And I'm liking this person. Whatever, that person was inspiring. But yeah, it affects you in a very...
True. True. Yeah. And the best part is that today that I am in my life, there were times when I really needed money. I would take from my friends. Calling my dad was always an option, but for some reason, the way I was raised, I never did.
Huh.
When I was in Aeon, my salary was 18,000 something. Definitely 5 to 6,000 were going back to friends the moment salary came.
Right.
Okay, bhai, there was 2,000, 3,000. And I grew up like that. So, I know what being humble is. I know what being broke is. And today, where I don't need money, my dad keeps sending me. Invest. Because he knows now I'm sensible. That I'm investing. That I am saving. And eventually, if he sends me money now, I don't piss on it.
Right.
But I think a lot of parents, y'all at least, lack that. Because, so, like, the one children who come from rich families, that the dads have made, like, successful businesses and empires. Obviously, you want to give your kid everything, but there is a certain limit beyond which you should not, because it just
things
is
go
bad
back
for them.
Yeah.
Then you have it, I agree. You want to give everything, I agree.
Then living on inheritance becomes the family business.
Yeah, and
I made mistakes with too much money.
Because
I made mistakes, like when you're 25, 24, you suddenly see a lakh. And there was a time I was 22, and I was doing my first job day one, and my dad randomly calls me in my office one day, and he's like, "If I give you 1 lakh, what will you do?" 1 lakh, right? Today it's nothing much, but
I love your father when he gives you such teasers as
like,
right?
And
kya
I was like, hey, you know, like I'm smart, right? Dad, save karo. Ting, the message comes, is 1 lakh credit to my account.
Okay.
Back then when I'm eating 18,000 only a month, and I know ki wo kabhi saving wahan tak nahi pahunchenge.
Did you?
I pissed off.
Yeah. Good job. Good job, bro.
And
that was a test.
I think it took me 6-7 months. First, I didn't touch it. The moment you start touching it,
then you're like, bada pada hai,
you
bahut pada
hai, 80s, 70s,
60s,
50s, 20s, guys.
Yeah, you know.
But that also happens because, you know, you as a young person, like for me, I'm earning money now.
Yeah.
And my parents always send me, like, save the money.
Yeah.
Or let me put me like, make money, but never stay with me. Yeah. I think it's actually pretty accurate. Because I never save my money, I always spend it on something or the other. And money is like, oh, I want this one thing. Like,
I think you should be clear with your responsibilities. Okay, I'm going to be a family man and all, so I should save. But if you're going to be a vagabond and I do whatever the fuck you want, who cares, man?
Sure.
Who cares?
No,
sure.
But this is also like somebody told me that this is your age to be young, to go out, to have fun, to buy things that you want to get for yourself. Because I don't have a responsibility right now. So I'm saving for what?
Yeah.
See, it all has a price and pleasure. And it's all required. Like saving has a price.
Yeah.
A pleasure has a price. So
when you spend, you feel good, man.
Yeah.
You feel
and
good.
And the problem is that, but for very short while.
Yeah, yeah, true. And it's addictive.
And you can understand now, I see everybody traveling on Instagram.
Yeah.
And in my mind, I know that money, where it comes from.
Right.
And I'm like, here, you've also gone to Bali now. You've also made a vlog now. Are you happy now that you're back to your shitty life now?
Yeah. they don't show that on Instagram.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. I'm like, so you sat by yourself, you edited a video, you kept shooting while you were in Bali.
You didn't.
And now you
Bali.
Sat for a day or two and edited it into a video and you're telling me you're happy.
Hmm.
I'm happy sitting in my room in my boxes having coffee.
Bro, tell me about your Instagram. How does it... First, tell me about your modeling stuff. Let's go there.
So, that Delhi incident, my dad was like, ja.
Huh.
Wow, we're catching up to an old thread now.
Yeah, yeah.
So, dad was like, go.
Huh.
So, I'm really thankful to him. Thank you, dad. I reached Delhi. And suddenly, I'm in a...
Shout out to dad.
Shout out to dad. You're awesome. I go to Delhi. And suddenly, I see myself in a co-ed house.
Huh.
I've got a Spanish roommate.
Right.
I've got a Slovakian. A French, an Australian, and a Brazilian girl.
These are your roommates.
Flatmates, roommates.
No,
flatmates.
It's better to have them as flatmates
flatmate.
Than roommates. I don't want them as roommates.
And I was like acting so subtle, but in my head, I was a Sikh all my school life, who had a dry life.
Yeah.
All I did in school was play football.
Yeah.
And suddenly I'm in college, and the haircut, thanks to dad, I kid you not, this is what happens in college. I walk on that SB Road on our campus.
Yeah, yeah.
Right here, that one road and then
right.
Left and right.
Marriott Wala.
So I would actually see girls do this. Right, and this girl comes to me, she's like, you're like Robert Pattinson.
Oh.
So if I ever meet this dude, okay, when I was 18-year-old, I would kiss Robert Pattinson.
That was when
Twilight
was actually
Yeah.
If I ever meet that man, I will smooch him. He made my college life so good, bro. I had this, it became my reputation in symbiosis, Edward Cullen.
Oh.
And back then I was like, whatever. But right now, thank you, Edward Cullen. Thank you to the writers of Twilight.
This guy will give him the tongue. Yes.
Frenchie.
I should.
So that happened. And
you owe him a tongue.
But this Edward Cullen was a virgin. So a girlfriend comes and I'm like, wow. And she was amazingly pretty. But at the same time, getting attention from all these girls I've never in my life.
Yeah.
So I introduce her as she's my friend. Dude, and then we'd fight instantly after that. Why didn't you introduce me as your friend?
Yeah.
I'd be like, kya batao? So college went in that, trying to be single but not being able to. Because she was amazing.
Yeah.
I really like wish her the best. Huh? She's married.
Okay.
Wishing her a happy, happy life. So college went in that, like as a party. And I kid you not, I'm really thankful for the college I've had. Aeon, Gurgaon was a struggle. Like, have you seen, I think I was quite filmy, and now with real life kicking in more and more of me, that Bollywood is dying, or the filminess in So in Laksh, that scene where Pritesh Zinta comes to Hrithik and she's like, you left IIM and you came back. And she leaves him, and then he finds himself crying in the garden before he decides to go. So I broke up while I was in Aeon.
Okay.
A lot because of my mistakes, because long distance, and it wasn't meant to. You're not who you are today. You're a kid. You've got your insecurities, whatever. I found myself crying in the garden of Aeon. What am I doing in my life? Financial fucking analyst, getting invoices out for some people who are working in America, so they can get paid on time. Like, analyst bhi kyun bol rahe ho? Bill wala kyun nahi bol rahe? Like, what was I doing in life? And I used to literally, I've not be happy. My colleagues who I'm still in touch with, who are my well-wishers, they were like, Gobind, you look like a dog to office IIB. Like, like, you know, like,
yeah.
And I was so sad, man. And I decided, okay, I'm done. So my notice period, I found this manager, I won't name her, anyone. I realized that she also smokes a joint.
Okay.
So my notice period, I used to be stoned in office.
Right.
Right? I used to go to her.
This is Aeon Gurgaon.
Aeon Gurgaon. She used to give me all the ingredients.
Right.
I used to go to the bathroom cubicle.
Mix it up.
Roll one. Chalo. Go to the office, niche garden, smoke one, come back straight to a meeting.
iCool, did you use iCool or Red Eyes?
I don't know. no iCool for sure. So Aeon finished, Chandigarh happened, and now modeling starts. After 8 months of being heartbroken, really sad. Like really sad. I know what it is to be like heartbroken.
I feel you, bro.
Being depressed, not being able to stop thinking about a person.
Makes you, I mean, it turns you into a zombie because you are there, but you're not there, right? You're like zonked.
I won't call myself depressed. I don't know what depression is, but I was not a happy guy then. I would get up to her thought. I would sleep with her thought. I would try to make myself sleep at 11:30 so at least I can get my life on track. Suddenly I realize it's 5:30, I've been rolling sides for 6 hours and all I've been thinking about is her. And then modeling.
And just tell me something.
That one word. Just
tell me something. Is it like? Is it more that I'm heartbroken, or is it more like how could she do this to me? Like
both. Bro, I was 22, 23. I'm sure it was
the end of your life. Well,
I was like, how did I not get what I want?
wasn't I the best thing happened to her?
And she, because the thing was, when I was in college, this whole Edward Cullen thing, she made me feel like a king. She used to literally have me sitting on her head. She used to give me all the attention 10 men would ask for.
That's what girlfriends
and
do.
And suddenly she would pull the rug under from me and I'd be like, ye kya hua mera? And I'm so naked, right? So all of that taken away from me made me really grounded. And suddenly, after being so grounded, I gave up joints and everything. But you'd always come back. You'd struggle giving up. It's not easy. And it's not like I was a chimney. It's not like I would, on a random night, get me alcohol. No. But your social circle is doing that. So literally smoking a joint every 2 days, 3 days, once. Which is not good. Especially when you're 22, 23. So you're not missing out in life. And suddenly I called her up. I was like, I'm in Will's Fashion Week. And she, on the phone, I could understand that she's proud. And
your
was,
ex, you called your ex.
Yeah, I did. So I'd hold on to my horses till I'm in a position of strength. Quoting Harvey Specter here.
Okay.
And then I'm in Delhi. I've got these co-ed
Was this
models.
Call because of, like, did you want to, like...
Of course.
Like, out of vanity and...
Oh, yeah. Okay, listen. You've got to be proud today, right? And it's funny how what you really want, and if you actually work towards it, it happens.
Hmm.
And I'll give you a lot of examples through this interview with me that have happened. And I'm walking and I see Arjun Rampal and I walk up to him and I'm like, sir, big fan. Like, thank you so much. And
yeah,
like,
he's got
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
Dude, you're actually doing Rampal right
now.
Yeah. He talks like that.
Thank you. And I'm like, bro. And he had that long hair.
He has that bad boy look, right?
Bro, he's standing in the corner of that bar after party of the fashion week and he's smoking a cigarette by himself.
Yeah.
Three buttons open. You'd be like, make him an actor. Like give him a movie. Like. So good looking. And I saw Indrani Das Gupta. And
who's Indrani Das Gupta?
She's like this big time model who's
okay.
Done. She's passed the toilet of
right.
Quite the icon.
Hmm.
So suddenly I'm living in this co-ed house.
Hmm.
The Spanish guy teaches me how to cook.
Yeah.
I see the lifestyle that these European, Brazilian, South Americans have. And it gave me a lot of perspective. As in Indians, we are really spoiled as children.
True.
I learned it when I was in 2015.
Right.
Jan 2015.
Yeah.
The Spanish dude sees
in, oh, yeah, I know. Yeah.
See,
yeah.
Indrani Das
Gupta.
So, 2015, I go to the gym and the Spanish guy just comes and does his CrossFit. I'm like, kya kar
raha hai?
So, one day I'm like, chal, I'll go train with you. So,
yeah.
He goes for a run.
Yeah.
Now, in my mind, I'm like, I'm an Indian. He's
yeah.
Spanish. Pride of India is on me.
Yeah.
I'm very simple to understand the way I think. So, I start running this entire perimeter of the park. Like, one done. He starts the second run.
Are we talking about Lane 6 Park?
No.
In
Delhi,
Malvin.
Okay. So, I start the second run round and I'm like, bye. India, please after this, khatam kar dena. The moment second round finishes, I'm on my knees.
Yeah.
But I'm proud that I finished with him.
Yeah.
He starts the third.
Huh.
I look up and I'm like, nahi.
Nahi, nahi.
India ho gaya. You carry the Olympic torch. This sweet guy who's still my friend comes back, he grabs me by the collar and starts making me run.
Okay.
Now I'm struggling. Every time he comes back, he helps me finish the third round. He comes back like 4-5 times,
right,
grabs me.
Right.
I'm barely trotting. Okay, he helps me finish. Now I start running alone while I'm chilling. I'm modeling. He teaches me what is eating, how you cook yourself.
Huh.
Right? And I was spoiled, bro. We had so much help at home. Somebody to like uniform. And it's privileged, but at the same time, I should have known these things.
Yeah.
And if you ask my dad back then that a Spanish guy teaching me, he'd be a little embarrassed.
Mm.
Because he expect me to know all this.
Mm.
Learned a lot from them. Now, all this while I was modeling, I suddenly start to pick up.
Right.
Slowly. First 2 months were dry. I was doing a lot of e-commerce like Snapdeal, where you just take 8 t-shirts in a day and you're like, 4 poses, next change, next change.
Right.
And meet some beautiful women, you know, like, wow, like, I'd moved on from my girlfriend.
Right.
But at the same time, I was really missing.
Huh.
So she was there and I never called her. And then while I was modeling in Delhi, I stopped talking to all my friends.
Huh.
I went in that luxe zone that when I become something, I'll call these people up.
Right.
And like, it was my IMA period.
Right. Yeah.
Right? That
training
song.
Yeah.
I literally, like, if my friend would pick call, I would not pick up. I changed my number. It was a year and a half I was on a Facebook or WhatsApp.
Hmm.
Wow.
So, suddenly my dad, all this while I'm doing this JJ Valaya fashion shows, I go to Jodhpur, where the entire fort has been made come alive again.
Right.
With ladies in aarti, thalis, and nagadas, and those five. And we're doing a fashion show and I've got these models from all over and I'm wearing JJ Valaya or Raghavendra Rathore and I'm doing Fab India campaigns. So I'm like, wow, and I'm making money. Like humble money, but good enough. Like I wasn't making this anyone, right?
Right.
But all this while my dad was concerned. Mm. Beta, 35 bika karega, 40 bika karega. I didn't know he's spreading my resume everywhere in India.
Wow.
While I'm modeling.
Okay.
So eventually, and in my head I'm like, fuck this now, kun fire kun is happening. I'm gonna be an actor in this country.
Right.
But modeling makes you humble as well.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Also, there were a lot of designers in Delhi.
I
really dirty side to modeling.
That's what I really want. It's stigmatized right now. So
it always will be.
And you know, I think some of it is true. I'll tell you an instance where a friend's brother, he's a model, and he shared this, a funny story, but he got approached by some agents, model agency jo hoti hai, or some people. There was a show and that's how they approach. They're like, okay, this is the procedure. You have to come tryouts, whatever. But there's a backdoor entry and they made it very clear that, okay, you know, you got to suck some dick. I don't know.
Yeah,
right.
Actually, it's the other way around.
Or
you got to be blown off and like, you got to be okay with that.
Dude, what the fuck?
So listen
to the whole thing. This is the funny thing, that the jargon, right? So he said, okay, you, but there's another way, a shortcut. He was like, yeah, tell me about it. So he said that you have to do something dirty. That's what he said. He was like, ab wo aaya ghar, Jammu se Rajput family.
Sorry,
he was like,
funny,
fuck off, bro. So he was like, okay, semi-dirty the girl. I'm like, dude, what the hell is semi-dirty? I really want to know. Now, here's the person sitting in front of me.
I don't know that slang, but I get the guy.
So tell me, I want to know what is dirty and semi-dirty, and have you faced this ever?
I have, but before I start explaining that, I was watching Diya Mirza's interview, and she quoted saying that the energy you, the aura you emit is the energy you attract.
Okay.
The first night of my modeling as fittings and fills fashion week, Rohit Bal looks up to me while I'm going, I'm like, thank you so much for the dinner, it was lovely. I was sitting with Carol Rachel, Lakshmi Rana, Sonalika Sahib. They're like big names in modeling
industry, right?
So I walk up and Rohit Bal goes to me, quoting, he's like, Gobind, I thought you'd stop for another cocktail.
No fucking way.
I laugh just like you.
Yeah.
Just like you.
Right.
So I was that straight.
Huh.
Or screw my sexuality, I was just like, that's not my way, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? And at least Rohit Bal was subtle.
Right.
It was playful.
Yeah.
You know, you won't complain about it.
Okay.
You're in fact be thankful for the compliment.
Okay.
So I walked off. So when I was in Delhi modeling for 6 months, I would get these I won't say pimp, but they were famous amongst models, young models who would groom them.
Middlemen.
Right. And I would get these calls from middlemen, ke so and so designer is having dinner at home, we'd love to invite you.
Okay.
And I knew that it ends up being a little weird.
Right.
Right. And there is a curiosity in me who wants to go.
Yeah, yeah.
Who
yeah.
wants to taste of the higher life, who wants to be treated as one of the elite models.
Right.
Right. And they do eventually get to be elite. Because
right.
they've given in, right?
Mm.
I was curious also, yeah, I want to be elite because I know I deserve it.
Mm.
You know what your benchmark is, what your capabilities are, what you can bring on the table.
Right.
If you know you have the merit, you have the merit.
Mm.
But at the same time, I was like, something held me back.
Right.
And I'm thankful it did.
Yeah.
So I would tell my agent about it, agency that was, and they really get me. They're like, Gobind, there's another way to success.
Okay.
And you can say fuck off to these men.
Right.
You can make your own success in this industry. It's a $1 billion industry.
Right.
So I'm saying this to all the aspiring models. If you tomorrow get something, be brave enough to say fuck off to these middlemen or anybody who's trying to abuse their power, because it's a $1 billion industry.
Mm.
And you can go there and make your own success.
Right.
There is, like, literally you go to Aramnagar.
Mm.
It's like God knows how many acre land.
Mm.
And there are like thousands of casting houses.
Mm.
Everything is having a casting.
Mm.
You go, you give auditions, you come back. And you know what I do? What people don't realize, when I go to my house in Jammu, I recently went, my masis are like, mere koi model bana de.
Mm.
They don't know that there are these middle-aged ladies who are doing a day's job in Bombay, who go straight to give castings, which is like buying a lottery ticket,
mm.
and then they go to their family and sleep.
Okay.
Because an ad can require a middle-aged lady.
Yeah.
Yeah, it can require.
And these auditions just need to see that, do you look good on the screen,
mm.
or do you fit the description?
Right.
Anybody can be a bloody actor. Chalo, model requires a little more segregation
yeah,
than that,
yeah.
that you have to be tall or you have to look good in the camera or print or whatever.
But
if anybody's trying to abuse power, times have changed, people are speaking about it, you can say fuck off. I've never witnessed that. Thankfully, I've chosen the people around me or where
yeah.
I go, what auditions
yeah.
I give or who I have dinners with. So I've never experienced it, but I know it prevails there.
Right.
And it should be totally out, because modeling is a beautiful job. It gives you beautiful experiences. You travel a lot. If this goes away, people actually realize what models are.
Hmm.
If I go to a party in Bombay and I see these beautiful girls, street models, the way they get treated, it's horrible.
Hmm.
Because let's be honest, these guys are brave enough first to commit to what they love.
Right.
They're anywhere rebel to their families. No father wants his son just to be. My father never wanted me to be just be a model.
Right.
So it's anyway difficult convincing your parents. Then to be a success in it.
Mm.
You're making honest money. You're sober because you have to be fit.
Mm.
Right? You have to be really disciplined. So you have to go to the gym and look the part.
Mm.
And then these humble, hardworking, sober people get treated like shit.
How
because of the stigmas or stereotype. I'm in my seat comfortable because I'm a bloody senior analyst in MasterCard. Right. I get my salary. I'm comfortable in my life.
When you say they get treated like shit, how do you mean?
Like girls... Okay, let's see. I've seen a lot of... And I won't name or give experience.
No, no.
But you see a lot of gold diggers.
Okay. Yeah.
So an innocent growing up man, when he works hard in his life, hoping that, you know what, one day, a beautiful girl is going to see my efforts and fall in love with me. When such men go to the reality and see all the beautiful girls go for like the richest man in the club.
Right.
who is pissing on his dad's money,
yeah,
who hasn't earned shit in his life, who hasn't created even one single beautiful thing in his life,
mm,
is getting all this attention,
mm,
you don't understand what's happening.
Or maybe you
but
get to know
fair.
That. Yeah,
but life's
maybe,
not
yeah,
fair
exactly.
And you have to man up.
Right.
So you keep working hard and you
right.
eventually hope that a beautiful girl will mm. eventually see the you
right.
and be above money. Or and let's be honest, we eventually all make money.
Right.
Right?
So at that time, it's like, are you ready for that beautiful girl who saw the beautiful you, or do you want more?
That's
another dilemma for many people, right? I'm just saying, sir, it's just
true.
Time changes,
true,
right?
True. Exactly. You don't know what you want in this, but I would all say that don't be disheartened if the stereotypes of modeling is not
mm-hmm.
good. I get treated with respect where I go.
Right.
Because I think I give respect to the art which is modeling.
Hmm.
I give respect to...
I've seen your posts, bro. Do you like... Yeah.
You know what I did like recently? I deleted about 35-40 posts on my Instagram. I'm trying to make it more filtered.
Okay.
More professional. I'm
right.
trying to take my personal life out of it. So my stories can be personal.
Right.
But my page and Instagram is not a social app for me. It's just a money
work.
Making business
mm-hmm.
app.
That's how it should be.
That's it.
Yep.
You want to socialize me? Call me.
Mm-hmm.
Meet me. That's it. Stories at all has a hint of personal.
And I remember you told me that there are people who created fake accounts to stalk people. Have you ever?
Yeah. I have never made. I've been. People have confessed to me
that
they have got second pages just to stalk
yeah.
people.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
their
yeah,
stories made their page.
There are a lot of actors and actresses.
I'm sure. You know, how do you know that, you know, Kareena Kapoor and all these people
are not on Instagram?
I think these guys love to talk, man, and love to talk, and they're interested.
You know,
that. What, so I'm very sure that most of the celebs have fake accounts.
Also, my page is not 100% organic. If you think like that, then God bless you. Like,
but I think that's the way. That's
but
the way.
Here's the thing. Yesterday, I got a call from Flipkart.
Right.
And I've got about 6 products at home to deliver for free for barter system.
Okay.
I've got a Calvin Klein perfume also.
Uh-huh.
They want me to just promote it on the page. Yesterday, I got a call from one of the companies and I said, I'm going to charge 20,000 for a post. Now, if they say yes, I'm making 20,000 for one post on Instagram.
Right.
I'm okay confessing that my page is not 100% organic.
Right.
Because I want money.
Right.
Khatam.
Nice. Yeah.
That is it. You want to see what I do in my personal life? So see my stories. My posts are all work. How I use my off days.
And I've heard Instagram models are making huge with one post.
I know a friend from college.
Right.
She's doing really well for herself.
I want to know a number just for the kicks, right?
And,
I want to know for
I'm
one
sure
post.
I'm sure she's making lakhs a month.
Per post.
No.
Sir,
per post
she's... Are you talking about models or are you talking about bloggers?
No, Instagram models.
See,
Instagram.
The one who are really successful, I don't even know what cap they have on how much they've made maximum because...
Because since you are in the business...
Now I've
just
been modeling for 2 years. I once got paid 80,000 for half a day shoot in Goa.
No, I'm not talking about shoots. I'm
so, just like that,
yeah.
If I started and you asked me this question in 2017, how much would you make per shoot?
Right.
I would say 20, 30.
Huh.
So, exactly today, the successful bloggers, how much they're making per post, God knows.
Okay.
I honestly can't. There are bloggers who are sent to visit another country and promote that country.
Uh-huh.
So, it's an all-page trip. See the incentive there. That
yeah.
means for one post, they make getting lakhs.
Yeah, for sure.
So, how do I put a cap or say how much they're making?
Right.
I don't
so
even
it,
know
it,
that because I'm not the most successful blogger.
It's all, yeah. So I just wanted a rough idea.
A lot.
Yeah,
I
a
know
lot.
This girl. She's literally visiting a new country every month.
Okay.
And it's paid.
I think my dad
for
hasn't
sure.
seen as many countries as she has as a 27, 28-year-old girl.
I'm sure.
She got divorced also and she put it on there and she's literally living the most transparent life and I think she's one of the real bloggers out there.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
What's her name?
Akriti.
Do we know Akriti?
Well, I could definitely get her over here and you should.
We always
but
tell people
she is a very dear friend and I think she's doing well in life. And
perfect.
You could ask her these Instagram related questions. But I guess I'm making, I'm getting drops from the ocean where she's taking us, you know, a bucket and so like,
yep.
give me
sure. Because there has to be someone, right? Someone legit who's actually making money and
but
hard
you know,
and honest.
You know, I feel like it's a very subjective industry, just like how... For me, now I'm experiencing designing is a very subjective industry because you have levels of expertise and you have different clients who approach you. So you charge them depending on how big the company is, how big you are,
right,
how
right.
much effort you have to put in.
That really matters
it's
how big you are, right?
A lot of things.
True.
See, but
true.
In the end, I feel you cannot ignore the fact that you have to put quality in front.
Yes, of course.
If you're putting quality, people will come to you. It's like a restaurant. You can be a, not a very commercial restaurant, but a, it's a JJ Garden vada pav. People know that you're very good, people will turn up. So if you have quality, companies will reach out to you, your Instagram will look good. That's it.
Have you stalked people on Instagram?
I think in a healthy way, yes. But there are certain, sometimes I don't, because I'm like, Gobind, if you are motivated to stalk them, might as well just put in that time into something more productive for yourself.
Oh, but
good attitude.
Good, but I stalk, like, my stalking levels are, you know.
I think you're even
since
interview started,
since I've started the podcast earlier, I was like, fuck your life, man, I don't have any of this. But now I'm looking at people.
But see, that's from a professional point of view.
Yeah. But I'm talking about the level. It's like a serial killer, bro. I'm like, level, stealth level, Ted Bundy.
A lot about people.
Dude, it's like, and you know what? That's how I scroll.
But that makes you a better.
This is the speed. Because if you do
it better at your job.
If you do it twice, right, you might send that embarrassing.
Like,
you don't want
they
that.
They should change that sign, bro. Like,
yeah.
Everything has to be hard.
That embarrassing
red
blob, man.
Thumb on it. It's really thumb is good enough on
yeah,
Insta
Facebook,
also.
Facebook is doing it right. Let's just fucking add. To your fitness routine, bro, your modeling is good and you have maintained a model like this. Better than a model, I would say. I think models often tread on the wrong path. I've heard, I've known
yeah,
a few,
you're
right?
Right?
And I'm not straight away talking about steroids or anything, but they just don't have the proper guidance towards
a lot of models.
I think
few,
you are doing it properly.
Very few models I used to look up to in terms of being intimidated by them.
Right.
So I would look up to them and I'd be like, I need this. So
right.
I would go to nutritionists and
right.
be like, how? And they'd be like, GH. I've paid nutritionists.
Everyone.
Bro, I've paid nutritionists.
Okay.
Give me the secret now.
Right.
Give me, I will live it.
Right.
I pay.
Right.
They start telling me, "Hey, karlo." 3 days they'll train me, and then 4 days they'll be like, "Change karlo na." And I'll be like, "You paid so much money for this." So, I have nothing against the ones who do it.
Neither do I.
Because I'm a model.
Yeah.
I require Photoshop on my pictures.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
So if an athlete is using some things to perform better, why not?
Yeah.
The reason I can't commit to, okay, here's the thing, and this is my challenge, and this is what makes me cry sometimes. I have to lift weights,
right.
to have a certain muscle mass to
right.
look good on the pictures.
Right.
Or just be satisfied and look in the mirror.
Huh.
Who doesn't like to have abs and a good chest or have some muscle, right? But I can't be too bulky or
right.
I can't come in too much of the age because
right.
then I can't run well. I play
right.
football. I love football.
Right. I know.
So if
right.
I don't have a good game, there are moments where I feel like crying on the ground. But then I remember my age.
Uh-huh.
And then I remember there are other men around me. So I can't cry.
Yeah.
And I honestly, there are...
Only because you had a shitty Saturday on football ground.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There was
that,
a night
that,
when
that
I came back to
football.
The ground. I came back home and I kept walking in the kitchen. I couldn't sleep. I wanted to cry.
What position do you play?
I love... You know, it's a six-a-side we play.
Okay.
It's a very fast-paced game. So there are times when I want to play ahead.
Call me in one of the sessions. Man.
Sure.
Yeah.
When I play ahead, it has to be more creative.
Right.
Because you have to dodge a man with
uh-huh.
the ball on your feet. When you're behind, you have to be really tough and on your feet.
Right.
Because you can't let anybody... have space.
Huh.
So you, I like to play different days, different positions.
Right.
And in the mid, you have to just run like a horse.
Huh.
Because you have to help ahead, you have to help behind.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful game.
I love it, man.
I want to do calisthenics
huh.
because after 5 years, it'll be more difficult.
Hmm.
In my 30s, I can't do or learn a human fact. I'm sure people learn.
Yeah.
But why make it a you know, higher mountain to climb? So calisthenics, I've started learning because if you're just doing weights, you're just making your muscles adapt to high, more weight.
Yeah.
But when you do calisthenics, you're teaching your mind how to use different muscles.
Yeah.
And it's a completely different ballgame.
Hmm.
So, and then you can't miss running.
Yep.
Because football, you got to run.
Hmm.
So your calisthenics or your physio or your stretching, I have to make sure I stretch.
Hmm.
I have to do physio because your muscles have to have that pliability.
Yeah.
So that when you shoot, they have that range to go from soft to hard to really make the impact.
Right.
Because of weights, if they're already hard, how will the power be generated
stiff,
for the ball?
Yeah, they won't be flexible enough.
So there's a lot going on in fitness, and I think that one who really chases fitness will be humble. Because body and what all you can do with it, there's so much. And I would just say do it because it feels better than a joint.
Tell me something. I've experienced this, and I've started experiencing this very recently. When you hit the gym, and you know, there are sometimes shitty days, and you're like, fuck yeah.
You just turn up at the gym, that's all.
Yeah. So you do, and has it ever happened to you that, okay, not because I want a good physique so that chicks can look at me, or just because I want to have a good leg day and it'll make me feel better. Does that happen to you?
There are times in the office, on my way to the gym, I'm like, kyun ja raha hu? Kuch jaan to hai nahi. I was 12 hours in the office.
Right.
And then this philosophical side wakes up in me and they're like, oh, these days make you what you will be. Yes. I'm like, okay, I will go to the gym. I will be a man of steel. And then I actually put Man of Steel on beats and I'm like, or the Supermarine song.
Yeah,
Dunkirk. Like,
we saw that movie together, right? Yeah.
I could connect that you're also pretty intense in your life. I draw soft outside. Yeah. So I there are days which are really emotionally draining where you don't have the energy, but you just, and I've stopped doing that. There are times when I used to go to the gym and talk or be there for 2 hours. Now I go like a madman.
Because I've always seen you like that. Remember multiple?
You have to.
Yeah. You were always socializing and working out. That was you.
And you can't do that. I had to cut out the socializing.
But I was like, yeah, looks fit. So maybe he has the upper hand. So he can do that. He's making other people feel shitty. That okay, no. Look at me. I can do all this.
Now, that's why I've got these nice headphones.
Right.
Beats. Because people understand he's not here to talk.
Right.
And you know, I at least need the first hour to be really intense.
Mm.
Second, I would come and joke with you, then go back to my set.
Yeah.
You need that rest period. First, I just let me be, man. Like, let me just
help me sleep
better.
It's a good feeling. Yeah.
But if I like have to summarize where I'm at in my life, I'm comfortable, Abhimanyu, but there's just so much to do. Not just football that makes me cry. There are days when I'm just walking in KP.
Mm.
And I know that I need to do so much.
Mm.
I want to write blogs. I want to literally be like an outstanding asset to MasterCard.
Mm.
Because to be a great employee also gives you great joy.
Yep.
People can say I want to do of my own, but till a brilliant idea hits me,
mm.
of that I can be a startup of something like Tesla or SpaceX, I'll just be a great employee.
Yeah.
I want to sleep better. I want to just eat up novels. I want to sit and just be able to write blogs, pour my heart out. Because it's only when you are really vulnerable or really, really real, people start connecting more with you.
That's the key. You have to be vulnerable and you have to be real and honest.
There you go. I
yeah.
want to shoot better. I
yeah.
want to network better. I want to do like really good. You know, in Bombay, there are jobs, there are models who are literally doing bride bazaar.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do Sabyasachi. I want to be sent to Japan for a shoot.
Yeah.
I haven't hit Ivy League anywhere.
Yeah.
I want to do an Ivy. And the problem is, now I start to think, my dad was a general in the army.
Right.
I'm not bragging, I'm thankful. Because he's shown me how. I had 3 fridges at one point in time in my life. Thanks to the Indian Army establishment, right? He had 50 guards at home.
Mm.
There was like barrack behind in the house with the guards of the house. And I've had a picture. So I need that on my own. And Army's not gonna give me that.
Right.
It's not a republic way of working, right? Ye beta hai general saab ka, toh inko bhi kar dijiye.
Nepotism on the highest level.
Right? And maybe I want to be in some Netflix series.
Yeah.
And I'll be honest with you, if you get up tomorrow and you commit 100% that main Bombay jaunga and I'll just be an actor.
Uh-huh.
And you work on your acting skills, you turn up at all the castings, you don't network people at parties, you
uh-huh.
sleep on time and you network in during office hours.
Right.
You will eventually find yourself in a Netflix series.
Hmm.
Or an old Balaji.
Possible.
Or,
so, but
without
you,
a doubt.
Your eventual goal is you want to be an actor? Like.
So the problem is there is so much in life to be achieved, experienced, seen. I cannot commit. I'd be happy if I find myself 40-year-old and I'd be like, yeah, I did that nice, respectable role in a movie.
Mm-hmm.
Or I was in a Netflix series which I really am proud of.
Hmm.
Right? Even if it was a bit part of.
Just like, you want
to
do it, like...
Yeah, experience it. Because, you know, when I've done these ads, where you go to Film City,
mm-hmm.
for Oppo or Honda City, and you get your own caravan, and the lens are shot ready, director will
uh-huh.
And then, I went to Coke, right, in Bangkok. And the director was Pakistani,
okay.
from America.
Yeah.
And he comes and I've got my makeup, and the lens are, do you need anything? So, I told the makeup artist, I need coffee.
Uh-huh.
Get coffee for the artist! And suddenly, they're running around to
uh-huh.
get my coffee. And there is a big bowl of water with ice in it.
Okay.
For me to pour my face into it
right.
before they start my makeup.
Right.
So that I'm like glowing.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
And then the director comes up to makeup and I'm like, ye kona shisha mein. And the director sits me down and he's like, Gobind, and I've got an actual baby in my hand. Right? So the role is I'm happy as a father and I'm really like emotional.
Oh,
so that day, you know, I felt like Shah Rukh Khan. Because
wow.
this director came to me before the shot.
Did you grow your beard for that scene?
Yeah. He's like, Gobind, I want you to, you know, have this emotion, and he's showing me
like a lookbook of pictures that I've taken for reference, and I want you to feel that. And they've got this demo baby for like.
That's amazing. And the things you get to do creatively, yeah, that's awesome.
And then this beautiful Russian nurse comes, right? And I'm not even distracted.
That's where they mess up.
And I'm not distracted because it's a real baby.
Yeah.
And when the shot happened, I'm like, I didn't leave her hand. It's only when I knew I have that, and they taught me how to hold a baby like this.
Yeah.
I didn't let go of that baby. And then the weird part is that I've got a baby in my hand now. And he's happily smiling.
So
and now they're like, act. They were glistening in my eyes. I'm like, not crying, but... right? And it was beautiful.
It was a true father moment of the time.
It happens
so
when you pick a baby up, right? If you haven't, especially...
Oh, yeah,
I didn't need to be the father. It was very intense.
Yeah, and
I didn't have to be my own baby.
So
I knew what a father feels.
I lifted a friend just became mother, right? So her daughter. So the way she grabs your t-shirt,
yeah,
right? Those tiny hands, man, it's really moving.
Grab a finger.
Whatever. It's just life. This tiny
it's
thing,
amazing,
right? It gives you perspective. I'm not saying that you
true
get emotional. It gives
true
you perspective that.
True.
Dude,
iske baad main apni life jee
paunga. Dude. I wasn't talking about that, but I feel you.
It's difficult. Yeah, so I really want to... what I was trying to say is that we should not put a cap on what we want.
Hmm.
And there are a lot of people putting a cap on what they want. And that's sad. I really want to be in New York as an asset. I want to be traveling for MasterCard, dressed up like Harvey Specter. And my day job requires me to wear a suit every day.
Hmm.
Why not, man? Why think cheaply? If you're at least dreaming, don't put a limit on your dreams, right? You might not accomplish it.
Hmm.
I do feel very sad sometimes, but at the same time, I'm glad because if that feeling wasn't there, I wouldn't move.
Right.
I don't want to watch Netflix. I feel more proud when I've restricted sugar in my diet for a month or two. I gave up sugar for 11 months last year, but that's also not good. You can't have so good of anything in your life.
Mm.
So I just want to like make each day count, man, and see where I end up at the end. Because if I look back at 2 years of modeling, I didn't expect I'd do all that.
Right.
But I'm given a job that I have, and I've still managed to do that. Wow. But I don't want to like get complacent because I have major, like I can be complacent in life. So I don't want to stop. There was a GQ fashion show I did.
Yeah.
There was Anil Kapoor, Shahid Kapoor, Vidyut Jamwal, Radhika Apte.
Right.
Right. Deepika was sitting right here while I'm walking. Everybody. And they dress up, man. Like they look
stars,
money. Yeah, like, and they were humble. So this party, this show ended. It was amazing, right? And we knew that there's going to be an after party where all of them are going to be there. I had to not go there. I went straight to Santa Cruz domestic airport, take
yeah
a sharing cab, and reach Pune at 4:30 because I had a call to take at 5:30.
Right. You hit the balance. That's
nice. And till now, I haven't hit that dilemma where I'd be like, I have to sacrifice one for the. There were times where I was seriously considered for a role on Z5 or Old Balaji. Right? I got really scared because I knew that I can't do my job while I do this.
Right.
And it's so scary, and that's why I have so much respect because it's also about how you handle success. Because if you tell me tomorrow, Gobind, there's a movie. You know Captain America, Chris Evans.
Yeah.
He rejected Captain America's role 3-4 times.
Okay.
3-4 times, I'm not doing it. And then this interview happened, they were like, why did you say it? He's like, there were 6 movies spanned across 10 years. He's like, what if they didn't work? It's
so
such
what,
a huge
what made
commitment
him change his decision there?
He just said, let's just take that leap of faith.
Yeah.
Because you need money, you're an actor getting a movie.
Hmm.
And it's not like there were other offers lined up.
Right.
Look where it got him in 10 years. The first Avenger, Captain America was 2008.
Yeah.
9 or 10.
Yeah.
10 years for 6 movies. So it got me really scared when they said, Gobind, there's a web series and they wanted to be the lead in it.
Hmm.
Like, job. it's scary, man.
Like, what will you do? Like, if you do get a thing that you want to
I
do,
guess time will tell.
But you also don't want to leave your job.
But I think that's the answer. See, he doesn't want to leave his job. Not because it's like, you know, I'm sure you can leave MasterCard and with your resume, you can get another job in some other company. But now you said
I'm building something there. I got promoted last 2 years, twice.
You
want to be an asset to MasterCard. That's
exactly.
It. It explains, right? You're modeling. If, you know, by a stroke of luck, maybe you'll get a good Netflix series
and
what.
Although
you don't watch Netflix, but you would want to star in
a
Netflix series.
Recently I did cheat a little and I watched Netflix for just 3 days to watch Afterlife.
You know, it's fascinating the way you say it. I cheated a little and I watched Netflix. Chill out, bro.
I mean, like, life right now.
It is.
Afterlife, I heard so good reviews.
Okay.
I saw it. And I saw that were only 6 episodes. And Ricky Gervais is... he's
good.
He's too good. So I watched it and I... House of Cards, Suits. So I have to watch shows like that to get...
I miss movies, man. I miss movies.
True.
Rather than online streaming, because movies.
But you know, when you see these movies or web series, you have to read between the lines. In these things that is not majorly part of the script, but it's where they define the characters. There's a scene in season 1 of Suits where Rachel comes to Mike and she's like, "You're leaving at 7:30.
Uh-huh.
If you go on like that, you won't last here for a month.
Right.
At least stick around till 9.
Right.
And these guys, you know, and then you see him dressed up again in suit. The next day, all sharp shape.
Right.
And if the stigmas of modeling go away, and if modeling gets the respect that as an industry it should, because the economy of Bombay thrives on these industries,
mm-hmm.
modeling and acting, so much money involved. So it's, how is it not getting the respect? Every job has a pro and a con. Corporate le lo yaar, 9 to 5 nahi karna, apna kuch karna hai, or to make somebody. Every job has a bad day. You talk about army, respect for them, but they're bloody sitting in Siachen, yeah. Like, is he happy sitting in Siachen? No. But that's what he signed up for. So there's a pro and con in every job. I'm just fortunate that my job has a flexibility and I can take out time. Or I don't want to just sit on my off day. And I want to go to Bombay and make more money. Because money, wow, I love money. I just feel that modeling needs more respect. Corporate job needs more respect. You can't say, why should I make money for someone else? Because you don't have a good idea what to do with your life, man.
That's why most of the things burn out and they bomb, right? Because they don't know that it's a full-time job. If you leave 9 to 5, you're working 24 hours.
And here's the thing. Here's the biggest thing. If you do your job well,
right.
You're always rewarded. You're always progressing in life.
Mm.
So if you are getting promoted and you're making crazy money,
right.
You would never see a CEO of MasterCard, you know, complain about the corporate life.
Right.
You know? My dad as a general was not complaining about the army life.
Yeah, why would he?
So just do well in your job and see then are you happy or not.
Hmm.
Why don't you first excel in your job and then complain about that job?
And exactly. And then you see, I'll tell you something. From an artist or a creative person's point of view, I cannot sustain there. I know because my mind wouldn't allow. I tried.
Hmm.
I tried. But I also believe that people say, oh, everyone's an artist. No. Fuck no. No, they're not. I know. Some people are good with numbers. Some
True.
People are good with negotiating.
True.
Blah, 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 blah.
Bro, and some people are just happy being good employees.
See, and they know that, okay, if someday, you know, epiphany happens and I'm like, I have this plan that, okay, I really feel for it and I have the resources and the capital to pump money into it,
yeah.
I might go for it. But till the time, be a good employee.
See, me and you can't be like arrogant about people who don't need to go to the gym. There are some who get sense of validation just being a good chef.
Yeah.
And eating that food.
Yeah. And have a big belly. Fine, man.
You're happy, right?
Yeah.
I'm happy to be around you because you're a happy energy to be around.
I feel sad when most of the people working 9 to 5 are cribbing that we're working. I think 9 to 5...
Then quit.
See,
I'm not complaining about my job.
Exactly. And I think it's stupid as well if you don't have that thing in your head that, okay, I can't survive because I need to write. For example, I need to write. I start going to these open mics now. Poetry, right? So that's what I do in my free time.
Okay.
And free, I mean when I'm not editing for podcast or when I'm not writing my book. So my mind is occupied like that and I have the clarity of for the next 30 or 40 years that this is how my things are going to shape up. And I'm willing to, you know, stay hungry and because I really like it. So I'll see how money comes, freelance,
True.
Blah, 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 blah. But plan is clear. And I know that when the time comes, I wouldn't be like begging in front of my father. Okay,
sure.
Yeah. So it's
that's the beauty of it. You make it on your own. And the reason why one is not satisfied today is not because he's not happy of what he's doing.
Right.
It's like, am I blowing my boss's brains away?
Right.
Am I at a shoot and the moment I turn up at the shoot, I've taken so good care of myself, which
right.
gives me confidence, is that people go, wow, man.
Yeah.
he's been going to the gym, or wow, he's been sleeping right, or wow, he's been taking care of himself.
Tell me something, another question that I really wanted to ask. See, you talk like you are a sorted man. I personally feel that you are,
okay,
in your head. I feel. But do you get this thing from people that this is a made up thing? Like you are artificial just because you want to gel in? Because most of the times people
I
do
can't
get
gel in. I don't have friends in this town anymore, man. This is like sex for me. Right? I don't remember the last time I went to a bar and be like, I'm hunting.
Yeah.
Or just go to my friend, bro, let's go to the bar and fucking let's lost today. I don't remember the last time I did that. I don't, in my gym, when I get
same
to talk to people after my first hour of entrance training,
yeah,
I want to talk to them. The
yeah
cool people in the gym. That's all the socializing I can in a day. Where am I trying to gel in?
No. That's, you don't get the...
Do you ever feel like maybe you want to do that? Like
very rarely. But eventually, you know, the good times do come by. Birthdays come by. Festivals come by. Marriage comes by. I just feel that... Just...
I think,
when I'm truly happy. And why I will be happy. When I'm walking from one fuck all place to another for no fucking reason. In that time, I'm not happy because I'm not sitting in a room without any distraction, learning how to play the piano or sitting on my email and fucking doing amazing job on my job or in the gym and really like sweating it out, having pain and still not stopping because I'm not creating something.
Mm.
I'm not whiplash.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
When he's just sitting, putting his eye hand
bleeding
in that,
hands
bleeding in the ice bucket or just playing, he's happy then.
He's in that zone.
He's in pain, but
yeah,
he's happy.
Yeah.
That's what I want to do every day. And the only reason I'm not happy is because I'm not whiplash ready,
yep,
in modeling or MasterCard or fitness. And I want to do naturally a human flag because I fucking did it.
Yeah.
Naturally.
Yeah.
And it took time. So it was
right
fucking genuine.
Right. So that zone, right, when you're talking about that, the guy's playing
yeah
drums. So when I am writing, right?
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter if it takes a month or a week, but that one or two lines that you end up, you know, you give that arc to that character, that feeling. I know what that whiplash feeling is, and that feeling is worth living for.
You know, it makes me happy when I see you in the cafe. Because I know he's not here for anything else. He just wanted a nice ambience around him, and he just wanted to sit and he wanted to write.
So that's the zone, right? It's like, and you know, it's really cool when you meet people. That so there's you and there's another one and one or two. That's all I want. Said you meet people. It's not like, oh fuck, I'm gonna leave this. No, I don't mind leaving that zone when I meet people like you, friends like, hey, what's up? How's it going? Yeah, mila, khatam, and you're back to that zone.
There you go.
It's that, you know.
Also, I don't like on Instagram. I'm following these dudes who I feel need to just pat themselves on the back, and they're investing a little bit of time of dissing each other. Do it on WhatsApp in a private group where
okay
you're just friends and you're fucking each other's case
right
for a good laugh.
Right.
But not on public platforms.
Give me an example.
There are like, recently I saw one dissing another for using growth hormone.
Okay.
And the other dissing the other for not knowing what they're talking about.
Okay.
Yeah, just focus on yourself. Just focus on yourself.
As long as you're not behind the bars, man, it's all right.
Don't hate on anybody. Don't hate on bloggers. Because eventually, you know what, they're getting up on time, they're being ethical about their job, they're using the time well, and they're making money, so what? Yeah, the quality and the content they put might not be impressive for you.
Right.
But you know what, that doesn't matter to them. If you see me modeling with what I was doing in 2015, it was shit, like, because I didn't know about how to pose.
You were learning.
But I was getting up, right? I was ethical. So eventually, I will learn to be a good blogger.
Mm.
I will learn to be really fit.
Mm.
Don't hate anybody, man. Like, even if they're of their own opinion, let them live their own life, man. You're not in a debate. Stop using Instagram as a debate.
Yeah.
There are times when I really want to. I see some stories and I'm
like, you feel like replying, right? But then you're like, no.
But you're
yeah
like, oh, when, what
but
you
then
like,
I love such people. So you have a very pure heart when it comes
thank
to
you
this, right? Yeah. I'm like more of, you know, I know such people exist. I know such people exist. Not like you. The assholes. I'm talking about the assholes. And I love these assholes because for me, it's all, you know,
entertainment.
Not entertainment, but content. More like content. Like, you need to see such people. So, here's another thing about army kids or people.
Oh.
Yeah. So, this is like, have you ever noticed that army kids are a little more sorted than rest of the people? Like,
but there's
you
a lot of army kids who are very snobby about it.
I know. But what I'm talking about is that when you enter sports, like you're playing, like as a kid you're playing sports, not like ground mein jaake bachchon ke saath khela, but competitive sports you're competing for example, you're playing for your district or state, whatever. When you are into such things, when you are an army kid, like your father is in forces, whatever, you get to see a lot of real people. You get to see the evil. I would use evil is a very, very strong word, but you get to see the negative side as well. The more you see the negative side, right, the more you see wrong people, people who are bad, the more you grow. It's your choice whether you fall on that place or this place. But the more aise logon se zyada milo, your experience, you know, it increases. And then it gives you more clarity that, okay, there are assholes in life. You want to be all pure and, you know, why are people complaining? Why are people... But then you also have to live in this reality that there are fuck all people who are going to do this, who are going to do this to you as well. And you need to enjoy it. You need to love it. And then you need to grow from it.
You know, when I travel from Bombay to Pune, you're just sitting in the car. So and you said no Netflix. So you eventually start to think and you go on tangents and then you self-introspect. If I'm sitting in my office and that day the work is not there much, so I can't really do much or make more of my time. And if I see somebody on Instagram, my insecurity would make me want to hate that person a little. In a sense of jealousy.
I understand.
So yeah. I could be a sorted person, but I would have a weak day.
Mm.
So that's why I'm saying when you hate, it just shows the most amount of thing that only thing it shows is your insecurity.
Right.
That means you're not satisfied with something.
It's
and that's why you're dissing somebody else.
Yep.
That has to be the bottom line. Uske upar chalo, yeah, you can contest and debate that what he's doing is right or wrong.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
But eventually, if you're not happy by seeing somebody else do something else,
mm.
do something else. They're doing something else and you're not. You're hating.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's toxic, man.
That's toxic.
Yep.
But it can come to all of us.
Hmm.
Because if I'm sitting committed to something and I don't know why I've committed to it, because sometimes you forget the larger picture and you see somebody get that sense of, you know, like nirvana because they've reached their result day.
Yeah.
It's their parents teacher meeting.
It's envy, bro. It's jealousy. It's there.
You have to control.
It's very real. Yeah.
And you can't have an outburst. You have to have a good emotional quotient. You have to.
At that time, you need to see.
Work hard.
At that time,
right.
You need to see the larger picture. You need to tell yourself that, okay, this was your plan. This is your life. And you are going to do it like this.
Perfect.
That
because
guy
when
is
I see
making,
somebody traveling, I'm like, Gobind, your value of money is more than your status quo.
Right.
Save this money.
Yeah.
Traveling, buying a ticket is fucking easy.
Yeah.
Having a good time is fucking easy.
Yeah.
Getting drunk in a bar is fucking easy. The more I restrict myself from fucking easy, the more I end up getting the respect of men and the love of women.
Mm.
And I love both.
Yep. Things we would do for that.
There you go.
Yep.
Actually, there's been a lot of outbursts about models being photoshopped on covers of magazines. Your views. How would you feel if someone
who's giving the outburst and why?
So there are a lot of them, like, what is her name?
Katy Perry was once in the middle of that, right? That she was badly photoshopped?
No. So there are a lot of actresses who have been featured on covers of magazines and they have been irritated that their bodies have been photoshopped to make them look...
They themselves have been...
Yeah, so they don't like it. They're like, why are you doing this to us?
Like,
so,
without their permission? Like the...
Yeah, without
that's
their permission.
That's just a quarrel between
that's
a model and a photographer made public. Which can happen, like in the same way I could call up a photographer and be like, "Yeah, ye kya fuck all pictures nahi." Like you
no,
were building up for so much, and I've had that, but I don't make it public.
No. But like the whole idea that you are being
portrayed
like,
as a perfect product.
Yeah, like that.
Okay.
Like better than you
so,
are.
Yeah, like, not better than you are, but like the ideal.
See.
Person.
You complaining about women's body being portrayed by Photoshop in a way is your quarrel. In the same way, men would talk about these growth hormone steroid men trying to take the limelight away.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see? It's both the sexes have that problem. Men, I mean, I have reached a stage where I'm like, yeah, if he's taking growth hormone, right, and he's getting a sense of validation and he's sleeping well because of that, let him be. I think the women need to be comfortable in their own bodies and understand that if some girl is literally a victim to a lot of Photoshop and that helps her sleep ahead properly, let her. If you're talking about the kind of influence it leads to young boys and girls, yes, well, guide them. Or these Photoshopped models or these steroid taking should be more open about how I'm about my Instagram. Tell the young boy, okay, bro, I'm taking a steroid. Or tell this young girl, I am using a lot of Photoshop. Please don't do it because it can make you very vain. Please don't use it because naturally the testosterone might not produce at the age of 50.
But what about, since your question was, you know, a Photoshop, how about this, that even though these models end up using, you know, softwares that enhance, what about the hard work that they've already put in?
So that's what they're trying to say. Like, it's all right. Stop trying to fit us into that thing, because it's not...
Are you talking about the perfect
them,
body?
Yeah, it's not them who wants to promote that. They are happy with how they are. It's just that the companies are making them like that.
Baba, we've got fair and handsome in our country. Let's not fight against the corporate greed, because
dude, on that note, fair and handsome, fair question. वो गले के नीचे कैसे गोरे हो जाते हैं?
Photoshop.
Ad में दिखाते हैं ना? Ad में
दिखाते हैं. But come on, like I'm a model. If you give me 1 crore tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Now I know what I want and I have got money, so I don't need to do what I don't want for money.
Right.
Correct? I would not do a shoot for Coke.
You wouldn't, right?
I would.
You wouldn't. You wouldn't.
It is Coca-Cola.
I was just about to
like
say.
Sweet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So yeah, you
like,
do also pick
because it's
it's
paying me well,
right.
And I'm at a stage where value of money is more than what righteous message I want to send across.
Mm.
Once I have all the money, I will be a good influencer.
Right.
Correct? So, you said fair and handsome. There's tobacco companies, they were ads of cigarettes, man. That's
right.
So, corporate greed does not think about our mental or physical health. That's priority two.
Right.
That's why they have on cigarettes, ke it is bad for health.
Mm.
But they're selling cigarettes, right? So, their priority one is money.
Yeah, and they feed on insecurities.
So, and the best part is we have to think about it ourselves. Like, we have to use our gray matter for everything. Till now, breakfast is the most important meal of the day. These reports, if you see the channel Vox, these reports that were published before were sponsored by Kellogg's.
Mm.
Cornflakes was the first breakfast meal before oats came or anything, right? Chocos and Kellogg's is only what we knew in 90s and 2000 till 2005.
Yeah.
Oats came later. And now Indians kya kar rahe? Masala oats. I go to the ingredients, see how many INS and preservatives are there. How is that masala oats fucking healthy for me? And it's my breakfast.
Mm.
Money is the first priority. Like, so, and unfortunately, I can't diss corporates because let's be honest, man. I'm doing an ad for Coke for money.
Mm.
So once I have the money, I need to be a better influencer. I'm not saying I'm perfect, but...
Responsibility.
So we have to use your own gray area. And that's why I'm saying if a young girl is looking at a Photoshop model or the steroid athlete, use your own gray. If you're telling me Cristiano is all 100% natural, I would have my doubts.
I would be scared to have my doubts because at that level of sports, we're not talking weightlifting or bodybuilding, we're talking
sports. You have
sports.
To perform, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. So I could that.
No, I'm saying that I think he's natural. I think.
You know what? Then he's an even more bigger of a Nike. Because then, you
for
know
me,
what? Thank you.
For me, he's.
Thank you.
For me, he's.
Same here,
because
bro.
He's one in.
If I didn't have any guidance, I would have CR7 written somewhere as a tattoo. Right?
Yeah.
But I don't want to be his bitch and tattooed on.
That'll be for life.
I'm yours.
he's leaving after 3 or 4 years, right?
So. And he's given us so many moments of joy.
Exactly, bro. Exactly.
So many moments
he
of inspiration.
And he moves. And he is inspiring. He is inspiring.
So if that's natural, thank you, Krishan. I would not take any steroids because you can
but, do it. But FIFA doesn't have that regulation about that you can't.
They do, but okay, here's the thing. How do. There are so many natural answers. Protein, you know, there are boys I know who've got great physique who don't even take protein because they're like, I don't know if it's natural. And I'm like, fuck, I don't know if it's protein. Is it or not? So, how do you know what is natural answers and what all they are taking? Bro, they've got chirotherapy and ice baths and everyday spas happening. I'm running now, right?
Mm.
So I've seen my performance elevate a little.
Mm.
So if I did this daily and if I had almond milk every day, how do I know where I reach with my performance?
Yeah.
It's one of my regrets in life. Ki main England mein nahi paida hua, yahan mein abhi nahi paida hua.
You just gave vegans a high five, I'm saying. Almond milk.
Yeah, about vegans, we'll go another day.
Yeah, some other episode. Yeah, let's not go there. But dude, the game is changing. As you said, market, right? So I uploaded the story a few days ago. Arnold Schwarzenegger with Steven Spielberg coming up with a documentary saying that I pushed it all my life that men should eat meat, men should. It's all marketing. That's what Arnie said. So it's a game changer, bro. And they're like,
but then I have to know how much did Arnie get paid?
Yeah, he's saying all that. He's saying
no,
all that.
Now to talk about veganism, you don't know.
Students, people,
I don't know, man. I don't
shifting,
know.
Shifting, bro.
So you have to
that's,
use your own
as you said, yeah, exactly. You
read yourself.
Yeah, exactly. You need to educate
what
yourself.
I have read so far is it says that red meat is bad, first of all, for the body to synthesize also. It takes more time.
the livestock does take a huge toll on the earth. It takes more toll than cars do.
Mm-hmm.
So if that's the truth, then okay, you know what? I'll never have beef, mutton again.
Mm-hmm.
But you're telling me fishing, which thrives the economies of countries like South India or
mm-hmm.
Sri Lanka, we've gone on war with each other for fishing. You're telling me that is bad for us because white meat and fish is not bad for synthesizing. It's not difficult for the body to synthesize. Lactose, well, you know what? Dairy is not really good for us. It has lactose, sugarose, fructose. You know, like all these things are not eventually so good. Fructose still, right? It's good.
Mm-hmm.
You derive it from the... But
sugar,
how are these
okay.
things good? How are these things bad? I would want... Just put it out there, man. Let me read it.
No, but
there's
also there is a thing about like...
I would like to see the logic behind
like, it. Like animal milk, because they are being injected with a lot of hormones.
That's the only reason. That's the only reason.
It is not natural anymore.
See, how can
I
you,
haven't been having dairy for quite some while.
How can you diss... I don't think dairy is bad for people. Why? Because how can you diss a 5,000-year research called Ayurveda? Most of the things are made from milk.
Yeah.
And
I love the fact that money has been talked
no,
about. Like religion, now I know. Science, yes. Religion, thank you very much.
Huh.
Right? Just like that, I would like the logic and it to be put in black and white. So we can stop having these debates and we all know facts.
But the thing is, nobody will reveal the facts to you because
put
there
out,
so
there
much
is
at stake.
Now this Arnold thingy, he's also saying,
imagine
I
how
don't need meat.
Yeah.
But say Arnold meat is bad. Say that, you know what, chicken is bad for your body. And I would say to the vegans that, you know what, if you're right, help me educate me better. But then don't fight science.
That
why do
point.
I have incisors?
But that's the point. Yeah, the belief that
I mean,
we weren't meant to eat meat is...
That is bullshit.
Because I can digest
we
it.
We didn't grow
can,
potatoes
can,
at the first week. We had raw meat to
yeah,
survive.
I can digest it.
So
it's as simple.
Yeah, there wasn't even fire on it.
And... I think we started cooking our meat.
The reason there
oh,
are certain
I'll
people are lactose
study.
Intolerant is because they were more from the primitive generations of men, where they were more thriving on meat. So cattle rearing and everything came later.
I think it's all...
It's so fact. I don't even need to read that. That's just logic in my head.
So lactose intolerant and all the allergies, right? It has got a lot to do with your gut biome. I think gut biome plays a very, very important
Dude,
role.
It
your
also
gut flow.
Has a lot to do with... So you know how they say when you're a baby... The mother's breast milk contains a lot of nutrients that are important for you to not develop allergies,
yep,
for you to
that's
be
fact,
able to fight a lot of diseases,
yes.
And that is why there are so many children these days who are allergic to every freaking thing around.
That's because
their
immunity took a toss when they
exactly,
were, yeah.
Exactly, because they did not get the correct...
They had Cerelac and all.
Yeah, which
shurume.
Is why they are intolerant to so many things.
I would just like to be educated. But the fact is, just like a fit person with a lot of abs or whatever, he's not arrogant in front of a person. See, does nothing makes us better than the other person.
Hmm.
It just makes us more aware.
Hmm.
So I don't like the sense of arrogance which vegans have.
Yep. And
I don't like the sense of arrogance. And this one person, she's come here and given an interview. She, you know what?
I okay.
Whoever, she... She said, you don't have compassion because you kill animals.
Okay.
So, and that shows that she thinks she's better because she's vegan.
Hmm.
Just help educate me better. You, if you think I don't have compassion, help me become more compassionate.
Hmm.
Please give me the education so I know what you're doing is right. And then I will do the same thing as you.
Yeah.
But I still not be as cocky as you.
Hmm.
I would do it in my...
So there's this feeling that there's like a noble deed that they're doing and there's this noble cause that makes them, I don't know, they feel entitled. That it's a fact that you guys are destroying the earth and we are saving the earth. And that's what pushes them. It's like, you know, people...
Yeah, that's
have
not
got
bad in
cost.
A way because there are people believing in climate change. I do. So
yeah.
If I was sitting with this guy one day and I saw him literally throw a plastic bottle into the river like that.
Yeah.
And there were like three of us and the fourth guy did that. All three of us were like... Why would you do that?
Yeah.
I asked him. And it's not like I would have jumped in the river and
yeah.
taken that one bottle away. But because now I know the grey, black and white in climate change.
Hmm.
Right? I've read enough.
Yeah.
Before the flood from Leonardo was an eye-opener.
Right.
So I like, nay. And before the flood from Leonardo, talked about beef and livestock and cattle rearing.
Yeah.
So I'm like, theek hai, beef nahi khana. I'm tab se nahi khaya.
Yeah.
Because it was an eye-opener.
Right.
So to the vegans, I would say, stop telling me that there is cashew cheese out there.
Yeah.
Tell me why is normal cheese bad.
Right.
Tell me that.
No, I'll tell you. You know, sometimes most of the vegans who become vegans, they might not have the proper knowledge, but from where vegans come from, I feel thoda sa guilty and arrogant because I still eat meat, chicken, cheese, blah, blah, blah. But it's like billions of animals bred into existence only to be kept in that farm, cluttered. You should see the videos where they've been kept, right? It's horrific. It's very bad. It's very bad. I started disliking that. Chickens, same. Same.
No, I know vegans have these propaganda-related videos where they show what
but,
goes to work.
Yeah, exactly, exactly, exactly. I still eat chicken.
I can't see that because I'm scared.
That's the point. That they weren't raised in a farm.
But tell me,
hear me out. They weren't raised. I don't want to have this vegan debate with you because you and I are on the same ground.
Yeah.
We love meat, right?
Yeah.
But the thing is that I do feel that those chickens, billions of them, they weren't raised in a farm. They didn't come into existence because the cock and the hen fucked, right? They were actually, they are like bred inside only so that chicks get crushed and unka kuch aur ban jata hai, unke flesh ka kuch aur ban jata hai. It's like a multi-billion dollar industry, and that's what's happening, and that's what ethical vegans are fighting for. And
should ethical vegans be actually for that? Because they should be like, we're not killing life, we are killing something synthetically made. Like,
So why are you doing that? That's the point. They're like, why the fuck? Because we have to feed people.
Because then they'll be happy. Chalo yaar, we're not killing life.
Dude, I need to highlight this point. And we should. Man,
like,
yaar.
Ab to wo scientifically lab mein mar raha hai, wo to life bhi nahi hai.
No, it's not a test tube baby. But it's just that it grows in that close area, bred in that, raised in that, hormones injected.
You know what you should do?
Only.
You should have a guy who's ready to stand up for not vegans,
mm-hmm.
and a guy who's ready to stand up for vegans.
I'm looking for...
And I'm happy to lose in that debate.
Yeah.
If it helps me find the logic like it did against intoxicants, religion,
mm-hmm.
and junk food.
But what I told you right now, that didn't make sense to you, what?
It did.
Or maybe you're hell-bent
see,
to
are,
go against. I'm just, you know...
I'm just hell-bent to get the answers for my questions.
Right. Exactly. So, if a lot of animals are just raised
yeah.
to feed billions, and there's an alternative,
yeah.
that's what they're saying,
yeah.
to meet your protein needs as well. There's an alternative. Earth will be saved. Eventually.
So, just to the vegans out there, help us educate better.
Yeah.
Leonardo is not being cocky in educating everybody about climate change.
Hmm.
So the vegans shouldn't be either.
Yeah.
I am not a vegan because I am not aware completely. But
and
the same way the people I'm surrounded with, I'm not sure if they are aware as well. Because sometimes they say things and I'm like...
Are you sure?
No, why are you being cocky? That's
so I would love to be told... that Gobind, this is wrong. I'd be like, fine, nahi kha raha chicken. I'm sure it'll be very sad. It'll be very sad day. But if it is actually for the earth that I live on,
mm-hmm.
I'll give it up.
Why not, man? Why not? I will.
But I think you know what, baby steps. First start with red.
Yeah, yeah, it's not cold turkey, man. It's
red turkey though done. Pepperoni is not happening anymore. Pork is not happening. Mutton is not happening. Rogan Josh, I've given up.
Dude, what are you saying? Don't
I'm
do
not,
that.
I've given up.
Nice.
I've actually given up dairy and red.
Dude, if our house mutton is made like once in a year,
because only
mint
on I went home this time.
So
I didn't have red meat, I didn't have dairy.
Because it's
and
bad for
your
health.
Because, from Kashmir.
Because it's bad for your health, that's the reason?
One, because I've read that red meat is actually not good as
yes.
compared to white meat.
Yeah.
And second, because dairy, well, cattle, it's
yeah.
taking a toll on the earth, so maybe.
Nice. Awesome, bro. It was fantastic.
Thank you, bro.
Yeah,
thank
man.
You.
Loved it, man.